Hey there people, welcome back to Is He Really Eating a Vegetarian Dish on Eat with Vivek Show. Yes, this is the Eat with Vivek Show and today is the vegetarian episode. And in this series, we are trying out paneer tikka. And like in the previous two series where we tried kebab and brain from Empire and Imperial, in this two, after the Empire, I am having a paneer tikka from Imperial. Why? Because in the kebab series, Empire rocked it with the kebab, but in the brain series, Imperial really did a wonderful job when comparing just those two restaurants. So today in the paneer tikka series, let's see out of these two restaurants, which is going to give you a better dish. At the end of the week, I will let you know which is the restaurant that is giving you a better paneer tikka out of this series. So let's get on to the show. And like always, Imperial's paneer tikka along with the box weighs 130 grams with a lid of 120 grams. I'm pretty sure just like Empire, their paneer tikka will also weigh the same, but price wise, again, Imperial is giving you a better price. Imperial is charging you 105 rupees for this plate of paneer tikka. And even here, they have beaten Empire in their price tag. Empire costed us just another 5 rupees extra. The weight is the same on both places. So now to see if the taste makes any difference. So here is a close view for the ones at home. The Empire's paneer tikka was a red paneer tikka. This is a yellowish paneer tikka. Let's see if this beat yesterday's dish. So in we go in another paneer dish. So for the first bite, I'm gonna take a piece of paneer with a small piece of onion. And this will be our first bite. Here goes. This paneer tikka is not a spicy dish, but Empire's paneer tikka also was not a spicy dish. Compared to that, this is less spicier, but then again, there was a burst of flavor in the Empire's paneer tikka. This is a very normal dish. In this way, I'll conclude right now, Empire has the better paneer tikka when compared to these two, but we've got three more restaurants that are lined up with their paneer tikka. So at the end of the week, we will know if they are better than Empire or worse than Imperial. There is nothing more to say. It's a good textured dish. The paneer has a good texture to it. The flavor is nice, but then again, there is a level of spice that is missing that I cannot accept. Having tasted yesterday's dish, I was really blown away. So this seems very, very normal when compared to yesterday's dish. But the flavor and texture of the paneer is really nice. It is not a bad dish, I'll tell you. But when compared to yesterday's dish, this does not stand up to the mark. They've added yellow bell peppers in this, which was not there in yesterday's dish. That does add a small, but only a very small flavor enhancement to this dish. Plus, moreover, Empire had served us a small box of mint chutney along with their paneer tikka. That mint chutney really made a difference, while Imperial has not done that. Imperial, you've got to take notes. Serve a mint chutney along with your paneer tikka. And please do make it a little bit more spicier or flavorful. I'm gonna try this whole piece at one bite now. It's got a slice of tomato, capsicum, paneer and onion. And I'm gonna see if this at least makes a difference when it's all eaten together. We are interrupting this eating program with a special message. How many of y'all have not yet liked this video? Please like, share and subscribe to this video right now. And do leave a comment and let me know which dish you would like me to taste from which restaurant. I will make a series on that too. And stay safe, take care, goodbye. Well, I'm back. No, it does not. It does not make a very big difference at all. I'm done with today's paneer tikka. I'll catch you tomorrow with hopefully a better paneer tikka than today. Take care, stay safe, and goodbye.